artificial intelligence and using it for getting your health information. My name is Dr. Ashori. I'm a board-certified family medicine physician. And of course, there are wonderful AI-based things that I use to research what I should do for my patients and for my own health. So how do you know whether you can rely on what you find in an AI-based search? The most important thing is to understand how most of these AI-based systems work. They're called large language models or language models because they're based off of content that was already made. So it is an algorithm. It is some sort of a soft trained on data that it was fed. It didn't come up with its own data. It does give you an output that is sort of unique, though kind of predictable, as we see many times in outputs from Gemini and ChatGPT and all the other AI-based algorithms that are out there. But the information that it uses is the majority of the information that it can find online. So what's the problem with that? The problem with that is the majority of the information that is written online is written by parties that have a financial interest. So if the pharmaceutical industry creates a bunch of research studies, if they pay a bunch of physicians to say certain things, if they fund a bunch of universities to do certain studies in that particular field, all of that data that is created, all of those words that are created, is what is used to train these large language models. So when you put in something about back pain, could it be something serious? Absolutely. It's incredibly important that you go to your physician, get an MRI done to rule out something serious like discitis, which is a serious infection of the disc in the back. But that's not true, because statistically, the chance of that is incredibly low. The chance of you having Cotta Aquinas syndrome, which is a very serious compression of the nerve bundle in the back, is incredibly low. And when you rely on a large language model, when you rely on an artificial intelligence model for your healthcare, the downside is that you end up getting a very biased view on your health, and you will go down that rabbit hole. You will go down the rabbit hole of taking action based on that kind of fear-based approach. Another way I like to do it, another way I like to use AI, is to first look at the problem that I'm dealing with. Then I come up with a couple of solutions that I could try. I would then think about some other bits of information that I want to collect to know, to see if these solutions could pan out. And then I want to be open-minded to my blind spots. So here's the problem I have. Let's say in my own health, I get sudden neck pain. I start feeling some arm numbness. Okay, so what could this be? What are some things that I've done? Okay, what are some things that I could try? What is it that I don't know? What's in my blind spot? Based on that, I will then go and use some sort of an artificial intelligence software, and I will put in my symptoms and what it could be. And I'm very careful about what I ask, the way I phrase things. That's another piece to learn. I'm curious about what are all the different possibilities that it could be and what is statistically likely based on all the information that I've provided. Then I use the output to look at all of my blind spots, like, oh, I didn't even think about multiple sclerosis. I didn't even think about a stroke, but I don't have those symptoms. What are the symptoms of strokes? What are the symptoms of multiple sclerosis? How do they usually present? How do most people present with those things? Well, I don't have those things. So chances are it's not something serious. Okay, it is radiculopathy. Oh my God, I have a disc herniation. Well, let me look up disc herniation. How many patients, if they didn't do anything for a disc herniation in the cervical spine, would get better? Oh, 80%. Okay, great. So I don't really have to worry. Now, this is, of course, helping you to do your own research. By no means am I saying that you should just cut out your doctor or your clinical team completely. Use your own best judgment. But if you do your own research, understand that the information that's there is biased. And you have to sort of manipulate it a little bit to help you guide on a wonderful path to healthy aging. So I hope this is of value. Leave some comments below. Tell me what things you look up when you use an AI-based system. What challenges do you face and what difficulties do you encounter?